solar. So since there is additional benefit of installing solar plant in a solar panels in parking lots because car will not get hot. So when can we expect that to happen in Chandigarh? Like if not 100%, 90% or 80% of the parking lots converted.
I think you don't know that Chandigarh has already floated the tender for the rooftop plants on the parking lots. And we have already installed a number of plants in Chandigarh. And new tenders are again coming for the schools. All the schools in Chandigarh will be parking lots. All the cycle stands, all the car parkings in the schools and colleges will be equipped with this type of solar high-rise structure. And we have already started 450 kilowatt SP power plant in the car parking lot in sector 32 also. And first system of 15 kilowatt in the school cycle stand. And we have installed in 2014 only. So we are already installing these type of systems, and you must see within few days a new tender will also come for the 500 kilowatt, 200 kilowatt one and 300 kilowatt one plant for the ISBT sector 43. And secondly, these are with the battery charging station also. For the e-vehicles, the battery charging station will also be there.
So I think it's good to hear that the government is already quite advanced and already planning this future technology of parking lots being solar powered and building. Even I read a lot of news about EV charging stations coming up in this in Chandigarh and Punjab and Haryana. So I must congratulate the government for it. Any other questions for people or anybody?
The query is with the changing technology and very capex heavy planning. For example, if you take 2.5 years back, the first bidding happened at 16 rupees per unit. And in 2 years down the line, it came as low as 2.5 rupees per unit. So the only buyer for this product, which is electricity, is the state utilities. So my query is, in the current scenario of changing technology so fast and the cost per unit, the purchase cost by the DISCOM is going down, how an entrepreneur can get into this business where you always take a funding from the bank for say 10 to 15 years kind of time frame. And there have been many instances where the state utilities are not honoring their, you can say, pre-power purchase agreement.
Purchasing by the DISCOM. DISCOM is inviting tender bids, and whoever quotes the lowest will be purchased. And these are the developers who are ready to give the power at such rates.
I agree to that. My point is, if you go just 2 years back, the same thing was sold at 16.5 rupees per unit.
I would correct you, it was not 16, just 2 years back, sorry. This journey has been in the last 10 years that tariff has come down from 80 rupees to 2.5 rupees.
2 years back,
no, your mistake is my friend.
So you're speaking about it from an entrepreneur's perspective, right? You have to look at where the opportunities are. So if you have the financial capability and you're not a manufacturer, then you are anyway in a position to offer best-in-class technology and use that for bidding on utility-scale projects or large-scale projects. If you're talking about it from an entrepreneurial perspective, where the opportunities are in other parts of the solar spectrum, I think there are plenty of opportunities across the board. You know, on the utility-scale side, perhaps for an entrepreneur starting off, there might not be a lot of opportunities to build solar plants because that size has gone up. It was less than 1 megawatt. In 2010, it's now, you know, minimum size is 50 megawatts or 100. So it's a very established space. But then there are opportunities within that space as it relates to using drones to maintain plants. There are opportunities about how do you make those more efficient. So on that side, I don't know what it is that you would really get. But there are plenty of other opportunities on the distributed solar side, right? So, you know, I think Simarpreet was talking about distributed solar roofs being used to generate power. I think there are plenty of other opportunities. So it's really about looking at those other spaces. I can give you my personal perspective. We've always stayed out of manufacturing. And it was a deliberate decision. Deliberate because we want to be able to offer the best in class technology. And secondly, we are not coming from a manufacturing background. So we don't have that skill set any which way, right? So I think that is how you'd have to look at it. But in general, if you take a macro view, just take a step back, not your perspective, my perspective, but a macro view, the fact that solar costs have fallen is a function of two things. One, manufacturing costs or installation costs have come down. Secondly, financing is being more and more available, right? So that demand is more. So basically what happens is you can now reach out to a much broader set of audiences across the spectrum. So we love it when prices fall because we can offer that benefit to our customer. It just means we are able to do more business, right? So you have to look at opportunities in a slightly different perspective. Focusing on just that 16 rupees per unit, I think, is a very myopic view. And you know, there are certain spaces of the solar sector where you and I and someone else just coming in can't participate in.
I would like to add to it. So this journey of tariff reduction also. The credit goes to the government of India. The way they plan this disruption is they emerged as the biggest buyer of solar electricity, and because of which of all this reverse auction we are seeing, the tariff has dropped from 18.44, the first tariff I heard, to 2.44. And so this is the start of the biggest opportunity, as rightly said by Saurabh, that now since the government has really developed this industry and the tariffs are at this level, it is very, very viable for all the commercial, industrial and even residential entities. So it's a big market open for all the kind of entrepreneurial activity. There can be a lot of financing solutions, there can be innovative product models or business models that you can come up with, and convince more and more people to go as well for their own benefits. So, I think this is the only industry which is now offering big opportunities for entrepreneurs interested like you.
So in terms of solar cell manufacturing in India, because in most of the government tenders now this is the pre-condition, and to fulfill the entire capacity of government tenders, are we really prepared in India to have that kind of a capacity, or a roadmap to really go over? What exactly is the scenario?
Anybody in the panel would like to talk about the challenges in solar cell manufacturing?
We are manufacturing in India. We haven't added more than 1.4 gigawatt of cell manufacturing capability. Partly it's because of the government policies where there's lack of support and cohesiveness. And second is on the demand side of it. However, when you talk about the current scenario, we have Kusum, we have 60 rooftop second phase, where predominantly, the capacity that will come up should come from the domestic country. So this is a good time for manufacturers to come up. But at the same time, in the same context, the time should be given to the manufacturers to start cell manufacturing. Because one thing is, you know, we can't set solar cell manufacturing overnight, and it's a very difficult process in vertical integration, right from polysilicon manufacturing to ingot and then wafer and then sheet.
Are there any greenfield
projects
going on?
Not that I am fully aware of, but quite a few small scale solar cell manufacturing has come up. Not to that much capacity. We have some in Hyderabad, then predominantly we have some even in Ahmedabad and all. But I think if at all there is any time that was good for manufacturing in India, it is this. Irrespective of whatever is the economic condition or the solar proliferation rate.
Existing projects, at least NR should have given one time.
That is true. And
please introduce. My name is Iqbal Qadri, and I'm an EPC company in Chandigarh. So that's what I'm asking. Because now all of a sudden everybody is looking for Indian cells, and the production is much less than the demand. So the government should have given some time for the execution of this.
No, I really agree with you, and your point is well noted. From the federation side also, we have been presenting the same concern. That even last week when we had a meeting from the stakeholders, we have recommended MNR that why don't you defer it by at least 12 months, maximum by 18 months. So that now the manufacturers know there is a demand. They will come up with the facilities, they will come up with ways to address this, the demand that is generated. But at the same time, there were indirect signals from the government when SGD was introduced, safeguard duty, and then when now ALMM has come up, PCD will be the basic custom duty from the
other side. Will be there now, but people will not be able to install.
Yes, that's a fear that we also have. We are very skeptical about that. That's true, but at the same
time. It's a very valid point what sir is saying, and I'm sure MNRE is also aware of this cases with MNRE that. Try to resolve this issue. Very valid point, sir, as you have said.
And then, one more question.
Okay, sir.
You see, Haryana and Chandigarh, both have made mandatory since, I think, it's 4 or 5 years back. But Chandigarh has made an effort to implement that notification. But Haryana has not made that effort to mandatory putting that mandatory.
Haryana has also implemented the mandatory conditions, but only in new sectors, not on existing.
Geographical
condition of Chandigarh and Haryana is not the same.
In
Chandigarh, there is no opportunity of new offices and new industries now.
Existing
we are promoting otherwise. By incentive domestic में एक रुपया पर यूनिट इंसेंटिव देते हैं डोमेस्टिक सेक्टर में पावर सोलर पावर जनरेशन पे एक रुपया पर यूनिट हरियाणा गवर्नमेंट जनरेशन देती है तो एग्जिस्टिंग में हमें ये जयपुर के एग्जिस्टिंग में इम्प्लीमेंटेशन थोड़ा कॉम्प्लिकेटेड है काफ़ी ऑब्जेक्शन आए इंडस्ट्रीज की तरफ से काफ़ी ऑब्जेक्शन आए क्योंकि एग्जिस्टिंग में कई इंडस्ट्रीज में कोई प्रोविजन होता नहीं है इसलिए हमने अमेंड कर दिया शुरू में तो हमने एग्जिस्टिंग में भी किया था बाद में नोटिफिकेशन को अमेंडमेंट करना पड़ गया था विद द इंटरवेंशन ऑफ द ऑनरेबल
चेयरमैन मिस्टर कादरी साहब का पर्सपेक्टिव बड़ा परफेक्ट है अब इंडस्ट्री इतनी मैच्योर हो गई है हमें ट्री प्रोविजन की जरूरत है भाई अगर हम ये सहारे के साथ चलेंगे ना तो कभी ग्रो नहीं करेगी इंडस्ट्री इतना अच्छी वायबिलिटी आज की तारीख में है सोलर के अंदर कमर्शियल वायबिलिटी क्लियर कट है कोई सब्सिडी की कोई मैंडेटरी प्रोविजंस की जरूरत नहीं है और कभी भी इंप्लीमेंटेशन नहीं होगा
चंडीगढ़ में पावर सस्ती है हरियाणा की जाए तो हरियाणा में यदि कोई इन्वेस्टर सोलर लगाता है तो इट इज मच मोर इकोनॉमिकल देन द पावर
समझने की जरूरत है अवेयरनेस की जरूरत है एनएससीआई करेगी हरेडा करेगी
आई फुली एग्री विद यू द नेक्स्ट आई एम ट्राइंग टू पुट द प्रॉब्लम विच आर कमिंग नाउ द नेक्स्ट इज दैट अवेलेबिलिटी ऑफ फाइनेंस इफ यू गो टू इंडस्ट्री दे अंडरस्टैंड बट देन द कैपिटल कॉस्ट इज
दिस इज द बर्निंग इशू वो डेफिनेटली अगर कोई फाइनेंस का आदमी है तो रख सकता है इस बात को यहां पे नहीं तो नेक्स्ट सेशंस में कोई ना कोई आएगा डेफिनेटली ये बड़ा इशू है
फ्रॉम वन बैंक टू अनदर बैंक The government says, circular says that the finance is available, but not a single bank will give you finance.
SBI is ready in Chandigarh and SBI is ready.
After the official,
we have